In this video, we're going to learn how to convert from milligrams to grams. And so our very first step is that we need to get our conversion ratio. So just like in every other conversion problem, there's a unit we start in, and that's milligrams. And there's a unit that we end in, and that's grams. And we need to know the ratio between these two things. So you can know this from being told in class, from knowing your metric system prefixes, or if you don't know, just Googling it. And so however you do it, somehow you have to know that for every 1 gram, you have 1,000 milligrams. That's what the prefix milla means, is that you have to have 1,000 milligrams or milla whatever you have to add up to one of your units. Step two, write the number in the problem as a fraction. So the number we're trying to convert is 52. And we want to write that as a fraction by adding a fraction bar and a denominator of 1. And now we also want to make sure that we include the units. Milligrams, mg, is on the numerator just as much as 52 is. And so this is important for canceling out later. And so now, step 3, write the conversion ratio as a fraction and solve. So I'm going to pull my work from step 2 down to step 3. And now I'm going to write my conversion ratio as a fraction. And so what that means is I'm going to take my work from step 1 and I'm going to make this equal sign become the fraction bar. And so now that the equal sign is the fraction bar, I have to fill in my numerator and my denominator. And I'm going to pick how I fill that in based off of canceling units. And so the whole point of this problem is to cancel out milligrams and end up in grams. So I want to put milligrams on the denominator, because that way later on it's going to cancel out with these milligrams. And so if milligrams is on the denominator, that means that my grams must be on the numerator. And so now I just want to take what I already had in step 1 and fill it into this fraction. So I had the number 1 next to grams, so that's going to stay the same. And then I had the number 1,000 next to milligrams, so I'm going to put 1,000 here next to milligrams. All right, and so now I'm ready to solve. So a couple of things. One, I can finally cancel out milligrams right here, and that's great because I'm gonna end up in grams. That's my only unit left that didn't get canceled out. And now two, I can see what math I have to do either in my head or in a calculator. And so that's 52 divided by 1,000. And so that gives me an answer of 0.052, and the units is now grams. All right, hopefully this video explained how to convert from milligrams to grams and you understand how to do that on your own a little bit better, and happy studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around and watch my other tutorials, and as always, happy studying.